And besides that, we need all the compost we can get for the Houston district. The Green Ribbon Project is an innovative design policy that integrates environmental concerns with project development, construction, and sustainable maintenance. Due to high ozone levels, Houston is considered an air quality non-attainment area. Challenged to reduce pollution levels and their effects, the Houston District responded by going further, developing design principles that became the framework for the Green Ribbon Project. Roadway structures and public art are addressed in the broad-ranging plan, as well as landscape architecture. Designs are based on the ecoregions of the district. The Green Ribbon Project seeks to integrate regional designs with eco-friendly building practices to produce safe and efficient travel corridors. One goal was to create large, native, naturalized areas that would reduce mowing and eliminate herbicide treatments. Using mostly native plants creates self-sustaining plant communities, which in turn maintain healthy soils. Now the district only uses fertilizers that are 100% organic on landscapes and grass installations. Adding trees, lots of trees, improves air quality and adds visual interest. The Houston district planted 900,000 trees in the last 12 years. The Green Ribbon Project is so successful that the concept is spreading to other districts, starting with those that have air quality issues. Air quality is important to all Texans, whether you live in a non-attainment city or not. That's why we have DCAT, Drive Clean Across Texas. In 2002, TxDOT partnered with the Texas Commission on Environmental Quality to create the Drive Clean Across Texas public awareness campaign. This program intends to change attitudes and provides tools for Texans to reduce pollution from vehicle emissions. Citizens are encouraged to help with five simple actions: drive less, maintain their vehicles, avoid idling, buy vehicles that pollute less, and drive the speed limit. TxDOT's internal program is called CAP, or the Clean Air Plan. Based on DCAT's award-winning campaign, TxDOT's ambitious program added 22 measures to the original five of DCAT, asking employees to walk, bike, carpool, or use public transit to get to work. Brown bagging and limiting workday outings are also suggested. Employee participation is high, and involvement is increasing every year. Employees can track their own actions to reduce environmental impact and monitor their effect on air quality. Figures from 2008 show participants reduced their emissions by more than 30 tons. As an agency, TxDOT avoids mowing on ozone action days, uses low-emission diesel fuel, and asks drivers to avoid idling in state vehicles. We conduct nighttime construction and offer flexible work schedules that save on rush hour fuel costs. And if you happen to be in that rush hour traffic in a state vehicle, chances are it will be in a hybrid. TxDOT now owns 141 low-emission hybrid vehicles, like the Ford Escape and the Toyota Prius. Soon, 3/4-ton hybrid trucks will be appearing. As our gasoline-powered fleet vehicles age, they will be replaced with hybrids. Alternative fuels, such as propane and compressed natural gas, power nearly 1/3 of our fleet, over 3,300 vehicles. Over 52 million gallons of gas have been saved as a result. Also, TxDOT began using low-emission diesel, TxLED, 2 years before it was required. This low-sulfur diesel even fuels our ferries. That's important because at TxDOT, we are dedicated to ensuring that our transportation projects and programs are sensitive to water quality, plant and animal habitat, and wetlands. Wetlands are the link between water and land. Wetlands banking is a system for balancing wetland losses against wetland gains. Wetland mitigation banks are usually large tracts of medium to high quality wetland, stream, and habitat ecosystems that are restored, enhanced, or preserved in perpetuity. They're important because of their great biodiversity, One-third of the nation's threatened and endangered species rely on wetlands for survival. When the construction of a transportation project, like during the construction of this bridge over the Trinity River, unavoidably impacts a wetland, mitigation credits must be purchased to compensate for the loss of habitat. Using the Wetland Mitigation Bank's credits is frequently more cost-effective than on-site, piecemeal mitigation, and it's better for the environment. Since each bank is an unbroken area, the native wildlife and plant species remain healthier than species which are isolated in smaller, disconnected on-site wetlands. TxDOT owns three wetland banks: the Anderson Tract, the Coastal Bottomland, and the Blue Elbow Swamp, over 9,000 acres total. All three banks are also used as retreats for hikers and birders, and as outdoor classrooms.
A snake's fangs are actually very, very delicate.
In partnership with Texas Parks and Wildlife, these travel counselors teach school children at the Blue Elbow Swamp how water sustains life and the importance of conserving resources. Protecting and conserving our water resources is part of our commitment to Texas. Whether it's the quiet, lush beauty of the Blue Elbow Swamp or the rushing torrent of highway runoff, it's our responsibility to minimize the impact on the environment. Stormwater is rainwater runoff that may contain construction contaminants and accumulated sediment and pollution. Pollution prevention measures, like silt fences and rock berms, are incorporated into the construction and maintenance of roads to reduce the amount of pollutants reaching Texas waters. Conserving water, however, means something entirely different in North Texas. In the Panhandle, at TxDOT's Donley County Safety Rest Area, precious rainwater is collected from roofs and runoff and recycled for irrigation. Built to improve safety by offering a refuge to tired travelers, this stop is a welcome sight to folks traveling on US 287. The Gray County Safety Rest Area is also environmentally friendly. Its wind turbine provides renewable energy to the center. Farther south, in Colorado County, TxDOT offers a safe and interesting break from traveling by offering interpretive displays of recycled materials and programs. And speaking of recycling, at the Texas Department of Transportation, we love to recycle. As part of our Recycle on the Job program, employees reduce waste by reusing or recycling office paper, office supplies, printer cartridges, aluminum cans, and more. About 600 tons of paper are recycled annually. We purchase recycled content products, earth-friendly alternatives to toxic chemicals, and energy-saving products like solar-powered traffic control devices and LED signals. Texas Recycles Day encourages waste reduction and recycling, and working with community partners gives employees the opportunity to conveniently donate gently used items at work.
Instead of sending it to the landfill, maybe somebody out there can use it.
The actions we take to conserve and protect the environment are beneficial, but we can do more. Environmental research continues as we study the effects of our construction activities on endangered species, air quality, and water resources. Studying how our projects impact the environment and how we can lessen or eliminate those impacts challenges us to design solutions that protect and enhance our natural resources. But let's also challenge ourselves to do more. If right now you don't recycle, pick one thing and do it. If right now you do recycle, pick one more thing and do it. And above all, dream green. Many of our most environmentally friendly road building activities began not as green ideas, but simply as good ideas. Fresh air, clean water, wide open spaces. Texas's natural treasures, our legacy, and our gift to future Texans.